Hello and welcome back. So last time we learned how to get data from our Excel worksheet into our combo box, and we got two types of data. Both were text, of course, but the one text looked like a number which we had to convert then into a number using the val function so that we could get our text boxes filled accordingly. Today we will add another dimension. This time we will also get a photo of the student that we select. Now, of course, you can have employee data here, you can also have item data here. So let us run this code and see how it works. So we'll click on the run button and we have the user form fired up. We'll select a roll number, let's say 102, and it gives us a message that we have selected 102, okay, and we get Hugh's name and his last name, his attendance and his marks percentage, and we get a photo of Hugh's. Now if we select another roll number, okay, so we get the photos accordingly. Now let's have a look at the code. So we'll go to view code. Now this, of course, the filling up of the combo box or the population of the combo box remains like last time. Here we define the f path, the file path as string for the picture, then we give it a value, so that is the string. Now as you notice, it doesn't have a backslash, so to take care of that we write if write. This is the text function write, so we'll take the f path comma 1, the last one. If that is not assigned the value backslash, then we add a backslash to that. Now the rest of the code remains the same, except that we now get the image here. So me.image.picture will be assigned the value from load picture, the file path, me text box 1, that will be the first name, and we'll concatenate that with me.text box 2, which will be the last name, and in quotes .jpg. So we will use JPG files. You can also use GIF files or you can use PMP files. Please do not use the PNG files because they cause a problem and you need to write very special code for that. So we will leave that. So try your best to take JPG or GIF files. BMP files are generally very large. So if you notice here, this is the path here for the pictures. So I'm going to show you that now. So here we are in the hard disk and the folder student picks, and you can see here I've given the first name and the last name together. So if you leave a space or you put a dash, you must code that also into your macro by using a concatenate function. So if you have a space, you will write and ampersand and in quotes blank or in quotes dash. I hope you found this useful. Thanks for watching.